Hi, this is your Daily Dose. I'm Dr. Beach. Unfortunately, we've met more than our fair share of them over the years. So today, I want to talk about how to spot, and more importantly, how to deal with a conceited person. Now, there are a number of telltale signs that you may be dealing with a conceited person. One of them is that conceited people tend to be arrogant, meaning they tend to think they're better than other people and they're up there on their high horse. Another sign is that conceited people always think they're right, even when it's blatantly clear that they're wrong, and they'll never apologize. Conceited people also tend not to give people other credit for their work or accomplishments. So let's say you're working on a project or paper with someone who's conceited. They'll often want to be the sole beneficiary of all the success, take more credit than they're due, and when it comes time to get credit, they'll want their name number one on the project or paper. One of the most striking features of conceited people is that they tend to be very vain and judgmental. They are often very obsessed with their image and particularly their physical attractiveness. And that image of beauty that they hold for themselves and they value so dearly, they also hold other people too. So they tend not to have respect for other people who don't prioritize image as much as they do. And related to that, conceited people need constant reassurance. And the reason for that is despite their veneer or image of esteem and beauty, underneath they oftentimes struggle with their self-worth and self-esteem. So now that you can spot them, how do you deal with them? Well, that comes down to the risk-benefit of having the person in your life. If it's not a loved one, I recommend you sit down and have a firm conversation with clear boundaries. And if after doing so, the person still remains a drain in your life, then they don't deserve to be in your life. And it's mentally most healthy if you cut the cord and have that person out of your life. If on the other hand, it is a loved one that you want in your life, I recommend that you sit the person down and have a gentle conversation where you provide reassurance that you think the person is great and that they don't need to spend all that time and energy proving their greatness. I'm Dr. Beach. Thanks for listening. This is your Daily Dose.